Dogs on the beach, rabies baiting, and winter fun in Barnstable. These stories and more on this episode of Barnstable Today. It's Friday, April 12th, 2013. I'm Sarah Colvin. From September 15th to May 15th, dogs are allowed on the beach in Barnstable. Animal Control Officer Charlie Lewis talked to us about those rules and regulations, plus information about rabies clinics and the spring rabies baiting effort. We share that interview with you now here on Barnstable Today.
The weather is so nice. More and more people appearing, and it's just great that the number of people who obey the leash part of the regulation. We recently had an incident where a dog versus dog occurred on one of the beaches, and, you know, unfortunately, the offending dog was not on a leash. And by the time everybody got settled and everything else, the person left the beach without identifying themselves. So it opened up a can of worms as far as rabies control goes, et cetera.
Absolutely. And really, again, I can't stress enough the importance of keeping your dog on the leash. While it may be very tempting to let your dog run free on the beach, certainly you don't know who else you're going to encounter, perhaps another dog, a person, a child, et cetera. So you really need to make sure that you have your animal under control.
Yes, and more importantly this time of year as well is the plovers have begun to arrive, which are federally protected. And obviously any dog that goes near them can be considered in violation, even if they're on a leash.
Absolutely, and you want to make sure you don't disturb the nest, the birds, the eggs, et cetera. So certainly important to make sure to stay away from those areas. And of course, you want to make sure to pick up after yourself as well.
That's the my biggest gripe about any dog on any beach at any given time. The number of people that take the minute to pick it up and remove it from the beach and then bring it to the parking lot and just drop it instead of taking it home. It's just as negative there as it is on the beach itself.
Absolutely. So a reminder to make sure that to pick up after yourself, again, not just picking up after yourself on the beach and then leaving it in the parking lot. You want to make sure to dispose of it in a proper receptacle. Very important to do that. So, Charlie, let's move on and talk a little bit about rabies clinics. I know the bulk of them have gone by, but this is just such a great opportunity for people to get their pets immunized against the deadly disease for a big bargain price.
It is, certainly is, and we do have some clinics left on April 7th. That one's gone by. 14th, Saturday, this Saturday in Falmouth at the dog shelter from 1 to 3 p.m., and there will be microchipping available. And they will license dogs for the town of Falmouth. Unfortunately, that's not the case for the rest of the Cape towns. And then on the 21st of Saturday, Bourne Lions Club is sponsoring a clinic at the Bourne Fire Station between 9 a.m. and noontime, and Sandwich Lions Club is sponsoring a clinic at the Heritage Park. It's the unit next to the Quick Pack off of Couture Road. And that for cats is 1 to 2, and dogs are 2 to 3.
Exactly, and of course, it is required by law here in Massachusetts, and correct me if I'm wrong, for you to get your pet vaccinated, not only if it's a dog or a cat, and even if your cat is an indoor cat, you need to get your cat vaccinated against rabies.
Yes, and ferrets are included in that as well.
Absolutely. So before I let you go, Charlie, let's talk a little bit about the rabies baiting program. Of course, a very popular program, very successful program that has been taking place here on the Cape for many years. And this is a program to vaccinate wild animals, namely raccoons, against rabies.
That's correct. It began back in '94, I believe. We had the first raccoon case in Massachusetts in September of '92. And this program began shortly thereafter.
And talk to me a little bit about what people need to be aware of. I believe the baiting starts April 29th. Is it going to be taking place here in Barnstable?
Yes, we're going to. There's bait stations, and they will begin to be filled on the 29th of April, and they'll stay there approximately 2 weeks. They'll be checked periodically during that time frame as well for activity, and make sure that they're being used and Then we will hand bait on May 7th, which is a Tuesday.
Spring recreation programs are underway in town, and Director of Leisure Services Patty Machado says summer programs are being planned. We take a look back at winter now with a great video highlighting all of the fun activities that took place during the cold months.
Well, it gives everybody an out. We try to get every child that's in the program as much as possible on the video, but we're trying to make sure that people realize what it is we offer and see what the experiences are. And you can see it on every young person's face that's enrolled in a program with us through these videos. So it really gives you an idea. And, you know, we put it to some jazzy music and, you know, that all the staff is working on. This isn't a collaboration where just one person pulls it together, obviously, because there's a lot of people working in a lot of programs. So it speaks for itself, you know. Get ready to move as soon as you see this music running.
Best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world. You can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up. You can beat the clock.
Yeah.
You can move a mountain. You can break rocks.
You can be a master. Don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the hall.
You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be the hero. You can get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people. Do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country. Do it for your name.
Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the hall of fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna.
Of course, you can view that video online at town.barnstable.ma.us. A contest to design a logo for Barnstable's 375th birthday is underway. The contest is open to all ages and all abilities. The winner will receive a $100 cash prize. Entries must be submitted by May 31st and can be sent in either via email or snail mail. Full contest details are available online at the town's website. Designers should keep in mind that the word Barnstable and 375 must be incorporated into the logo. With Barnstable Today, I'm Sarah Colvin.